Hey y'all, Dax here. Today, we'll be reviewing every single Nintendo controller. Nope, I'm not counting handhelds, that's for the next video. And nope, I'm not counting the Wii U because one, I couldn't find anyone that had one, and two, in my opinion, it's not a console. But let's get started with the NES controller. This was borrowed from my friend Tyler, so thank you, Tyler. Here is the NES controller, it is lovely. So we got the Nintendo logo up here. And we got A here, B here, start here, and select here. And then we got the D-pad, so, you know, you can drift in Mario Kart. One thing I'd like to say about it, the A and B buttons are kind of hard to press. Like, not super hard, just a tiny bit hard. These start and select buttons feel pretty great. But this D-pad, I'm not really sure about it. It's not my favorite, but, you know. Now, the next controller. The Super NES controller. This controller was much, much better. Because the last one, since it was square, when you play for a long time, it hurt your hands. And this one added shoulder buttons. So as you can see here, you know, it added four more buttons. So A and B are the same, start, select are the same, D-pad is the same. But they added X, Y, and the two shoulder buttons, L and R. Whew. My opinion on this controller, it is amazing. I love it. It really fits in the hand. And, yeah. The start, select are amazing. Pretty good. They've definitely mastered the D-pad. It just has a little click, and that's just amazing. Shoulder buttons are not the best, but, you know, it's the first time having them. They'll learn. And let's move up. This is the N64 controller, borrowed from my friend Preston. This one was actually kind of hard to find. All right, this thing, there's a lot to go over, but let's start with the D-pad. D-pad, this is, I think, when they've mastered it. It's just the perfect. And then let's move to the buttons. So we got this C thing, which I'm not quite sure what it's for, but it's pretty cool. They removed X and Y, but, you know, still got A and B, got the start button, and when you're holding it like this, you still have the L and R buttons, and these feel real nice. Now let's move to this center thing, and oh boy. So the idea is that some games you would use this and this, but other games, like 3D games, like Mario 64, you'd use this to move around, and on the bottom, as you can see, yep, there's that. So, it still maintains full functionality, and I do like this one. Alright, next up is the GameCube controllers. These were both borrowed from my friend Nick once again. Thank you very much. Alright, we're gonna start out with the classic purple. Yeah. I love how small. And it's just amazing. Ugh, this is mostly used for camera, so if you're, you know, going through, you can, this is usually used to move the camera. The start slash pause button, it is a little weird, but, you know, that's been on every single controller ever since. These, on this one, the A and B buttons are kind of, I'll just say they're a little snappy. I don't like them. Let's move to the, what is that? Yes, it only has one shoulder button. But at least they added the triggers, which these are the best triggers in Nintendo. They have a digital press when you do this and an actual press. I don't know if you can hear that click. Anyway, it's amazing. And then is one of my favorite controllers, the Wii controller. Man, this thing has a lot of memories for me. This was also borrowed from my friend Nick. Thank you, Nick. You have come in clutch for this video. And, so, the one thing that is weird about the Wii, in my opinion, is this nunchuck accessory is what they called it, but we'll get to that later. Okay, so this is the Wii remote. So, back here, it's got one trigger. And, you know, when I do that, the buttons flash up. They're like, you know, searching for a Wii to connect to. But I don't have a Wii. I used to have a Wii, but my brother traded it for an Xbox One. So, this D-pad is, like, the peak. It's just amazing. Big A button, perfect. This power button up here to, you know, turn on Wii. Plus and minus, first time we've seen those in a while. And then, you know, the Wii Home. I think I already talked about the trigger. And then we got these 1 and 2 buttons. Pretty cool. I like them. And then we get to this. This thing. I don't even know if you can call this a controller. But it was just to give you this so you could, you know, explore some 3D environments. And then, you know, you have an extra trigger. And I'm guessing this is supposed to be a bumper. I don't know. I haven't played on a Wii in a while. And then we move to the last and latest controller. The Wii. I'm just kidding. I don't have a Wii U gamepad. But I do have the Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons. Look at this! It's the Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons! Well, this was borrowed from my friend Daxton. It's me. I have a new Switch. So, D-pad. Well, it's not really D-pad, but I mean, it's just buttons, but I know they wanted to make it so, you know, it could be two. Wait. Oh, did my Switch just turn on?
I'm taking the hand cam because I think the Joy-Cons just turned my Switch on. Oh yeah, that's on. Oh, whoops.
Yeah, it did turn my Switch on, but I'm gonna... So, D-pad, meh. These joysticks, alright, just say it right now and get it over with. Joy-Con drift! Anyway, they have actual bumpers and triggers, very nice. And then we have these two buttons to connect it when it's sideways. Overall, these, I like this. Which controller is your favorite? There's quite a lot of them.
But my favorite controller is the GameCube controller. Thank you, Nick, for lending this to me.
Thank you to everyone who lent me controllers. This video would not have been possible without them. Also, the